Frank McLaughlin here with another video, and today's question that I want to address is, can I retire with $1 million? Well, the magic answer is maybe. So let's dive in. Arguably the largest factor that goes into when you can retire is your expenses or your cash flow needs. So start by listing those out. Think about your mortgage, if you still have one, any other debt payments such as car payments, and then also just your everyday living, food expenses, travel, insurance. Add up all of that to get a monthly amount of what you need to spend and also what you want to spend. Also, to the best of your ability, this number needs to be forward-looking. And what I mean when I say that is, once you retire, how will things look differently? Maybe you'll have to start paying for private medical insurance, which could be an extra expense since you had been used to being on your employer's plan. Don't forget about Medicare, and also increased hobbies. If you have more time, maybe you're traveling more, spending more on that. What do you want that dollar amount to look like? After you've figured out your expenses or your cost of living, now it's time to take a look and take track of your retirement income. Usually, this may involve a pension. You also want to confirm if that pension has a cost of living adjustment, whether or not it's going to go up with inflation or just stay the same, because that will have a huge impact. And then also look at Social Security. I would then recommend starting by offsetting that retirement income with the expenses or the cost of living, knowing that those costs are going to go up at least by inflation. And when it comes to things such as medical expenses, they tend to rise even faster than inflation. So keep that in mind. Now, let's say that after figuring out your cash needs, comes to a total of $80,000 per year that you and your family want to be able to spend, or about $6,667 per month. Now, if you're watching this, you may think that number sounds extremely low, you may think that number sounds high, and that's okay. Everyone's situation is extremely unique. I'm just giving an example for today, but let's say that number is $80,000. And between pensions, Social Security, your retirement income is going to be $40,000 per year. Well, then using those to offset, that leaves a difference of $40,000 that will need to be covered by investments, cash, or other areas. Now, this is where that $1 million number comes in. So let's say that you have $1 million in investments, other assets, retirement accounts, and for today's purposes, it's well diversified and you can expect to achieve a return of 5.5% to 6.5% on average every year. Typically, at this point, I would run a complex reporting tool called a Monte Carlo analysis that runs 1,000 different scenarios of possible investment returns for that $1 million and gives you a percentage chance of being able to spend that amount, $80,000 per year with the $40,000 from the portfolio. But since this is something that you're doing on your own at home, we can stick with the old 4% rule for today's example. The 4% rule is a general rule of thumb that states that if your accounts, your investments are properly allocated and getting you a good amount of growth without taking additional risk, then you can afford to pull 4% from your portfolio forever. In the example that we started, that family wanted to be able to spend $80,000 per year. We figured out that $40,000 of it would be covered by retirement income, which left $40,000 per year that needed to be pulled from their investment portfolio. Now, with $1 million, 4% of that is $40,000. So that family could potentially be okay for retiring. If that same family had wanted to spend $100,000 per year, then they may not be able to retire right now. They may need to work longer or reduce what they want to be able to spend, reduce some travel in retirement. It's important to remember that retirement planning is oftentimes much more complex than you realize, and there's going to be a lot of expenses, especially medical emergencies, that don't fit into that neat budget or neat cost of living that you've drawn out. And so today is purely an example. It's not a recommendation, it's just ideas to start getting you thinking, start getting you to list out your expenses.